Kenya has recorded the highest number of new infections since the first case was reported in March. 1,395 people have tested positive, bringing to 55,192 the cumulative number of infections. Now, October has been the month with the highest COVID-19 infections among health workers. According to the latest data from the Ministry of Health, released Thursday, October 29th, 1,586 health workers have been infected, with 18 deaths reported in 41 counties.
Health workers in Kenya, the last line of defense in the fight against COVID-19, continue to be severely infected and affected by the virus. From doctors, nurses, lab technicians, anesthetists and ICU staff, housekeeping staff and those who take care of biomedical waste, the Ministry of Health, by Thursday, October 29th, had documented 1,586 health workers who have been infected cumulatively, with 18 deaths reported in 41 counties.
In the month of October, we've witnessed the highest number of health workers' infections. So we are calling upon the government to ensure that healthcare workers are, one, provided with comprehensive medical insurance cover, and two, compensated. Will not accept any more healthcare workers being the martyrs.
According to KMPDU, the counties where health workers have been most affected are Nairobi with 505 health workers, Uasin Gishu 161, Mombasa 142, Kiambu 97, Kajiado 79, Garissa 50. And with doctors in Nairobi on strike for more than 2 weeks and counting over an adequate and comprehensive insurance cover, the union says the fight will be lost in the county. The latest death due to COVID-19 complications is that of Dr. Daniel Alushula, a renowned orthopedic surgeon who was working at the Busia County Referral Hospital. NMS Health Director Dr. Ouma Oluga's tribute reads, and I quote, "You did your work on earth with passion, going beyond the call of duty to treat trauma and orthopedic patients with dedication. You actively participated in our quest to reform the system. We shall miss you," end of quote. And Kakamega Governor Weekly for Paranyas reads, "The death of Dr. Daniel Alushula has robbed us a renowned orthopedic surgeon whose medical services have saved many lives. He was a competent, diligent and humble doctor who devoted his life to saving lives and serving people," end of quote. In the last 24 hours, 1,395 people have tested positive for COVID-19, the highest number recorded since the onset of the pandemic in March. This brings to 55,192 the number of confirmed positive cases in the country, the result showing from 7,635 samples with a test positivity rate of 18.3%. 15 patients have succumbed, bringing the fatality to 996. 1,087 recoveries have been recorded, bringing the total number of recoveries to 36,963. The most affected counties are Nairobi with 569 cases, Nakuru 149, Kiambu 148, Mombasa 147, Uasin Gishu 60, Kilifi 41, and Kericho 30. Rapid response teams have stopped admitting new cases to Alupe Busia due to shortage of food and insecurity at the facility. Food suppliers demand to be paid upfront, while the county insists on paying after delivery. Currently, there are 34 cases in isolation at the Busia GK prison. In addition, the holding room at the Busia point of entry has no electricity and water at the moment. The point of entry staff are waiting for funds to fix these utilities. And with infections being on an upward trajectory, health workers are now calling out the political leadership for failing them in the fight against the virus.
Political leaders must take responsibility on this matter of COVID. And so as healthcare workers, we are the ones who will be left to handle the burden of rising infections. So today we'd like to tell the political leadership of this country that you need to support healthcare workers by downscaling this heightened political activity.
Kenya is literally in the eye of a storm as far as COVID-19 is concerned. With the scales up, this has been a record-setting week and month since the pandemic started. Dorcas Wangira, Citizen TV, Nairobi.